Hi everyone, I'm Sunks, one of the co-founders of Recall, and I'm super excited about this video because I'll be walking you through my personal use case of Recall, and hopefully that will inspire some of you to find some use cases of your own. So this is my personal Recall knowledge base. I'm using it for all my research on health and longevity, for all of my favorite movies and movie recommendations, even personal journals. I don't need to share that one. And also my recipes. So whether that's online recipes or recipes that I just like to take myself, I really have this vast range of use cases that I will walk you through. I think first, let me just talk you through my setup of Recall. So primarily I use Recall on the desktop using the web app. So when you log in on our website, you can click open app and that will just take you to your Recall knowledge base. I also have the Chrome browser extension installed and I love that because when I'm browsing and topics are coming up, I love that I can quickly either get a summary or chat with my content or just save it into Recall and I know it's in a safe place. Just on my settings, so my browser extension settings in particular, I have it on concise summary. You can just switch it to whatever you prefer. I have augmented browsing installed. I'll talk you through that use case in a little bit. And I also have the Recall widget installed. So just a reminder on what that is. It's this little pop-up that shows up on some pages where you can then just quickly skip to a concise summary of that content or a detailed summary, whatever it is that you might be looking at. I actually have autosave turned off. So some people like autosave on so they don't have to think too much as they're browsing. They just hit the extension and content is saved to Recall. But I actually like having it off just because I think a little bit more about, is this something that I actually want in my knowledge base or not? And I also love using Recall on my mobile app. When I'm out and about and a friend gives me a movie recommendation or before I listen to a long podcast, I'll just run it through Recall as a bit of a precursor. And so that's really my setup. So the web app, the browser extension, and the mobile app. I think I'll spend a little bit of time on that first use case, which I had mentioned on health and longevity. And so today there are just, you know, there is just so much great content out there when it comes to how you can optimize your fitness, your health, your productivity. But a lot of it is really long form content. In this example, what is the surprising truth about creatine? That's something I'd be interested in, you know, getting the full content on. But it's a 3-hour long YouTube video. And I'm sure like many of you watching this, where are you finding the 3 hours to commit to the full video? And so this is also a bit clickbaity. Missing this vitamin is as bad as smoking. But I have to admit these things get to me sometimes. And I just want to know, you know, what's the vitamin? What's the truth about creatine? And that's where having the browser extension just gives me that quick, concise summary if I just want to, yeah, skip through the content before committing to the full video. I also, just a small thing, I like to lock the extension in place. When you click away, if it's not locked, it disappears, which can be a little bit annoying. So I like to lock it in place. I'm also happy with the tag or category it gave. So in this case, health and aging. I've been using Recall for a long time, so my categories are pretty stable and it's actually gotten pretty good at getting the right tag. Not always. And then I spend a little bit of time doing some housekeeping, cleaning it up. But in this case, I'm fine with it. And for something like this, I would actually ask a question in the browser extension. So I would say, what is the surprising truth about creatine? And just a reminder, here you're actually chatting with the video, right? So the what's been fed into the chat is the actual video itself. So that's where the answer is coming from. So here I can get some great key points on what is the surprising truth about creatine. This is something that I would then save to my notebook. So in this tab, I have the notebook, which contains the summary. And then now it's also got my question and my answer. I can then also skip to particular parts that I might find interesting. So this mentions creatine and the brain. So I can just skip to that part in the video if I want to watch it.
So there are studies that have shown.
If I see something that's interesting, I would then, you know, highlight that. I might even, while I'm watching take some notes so this reminds me of whatever my note might be. And then I would just save that into Recall. So it's great because here I've got my concise summary, I've got that question that I've asked, and I've also got all of my highlights. I also, maybe not for a YouTube video, but I do like the split screen view just because I have the full content on the left and then I have my concise summary, my chats, or whatever it might be doing. So I still have that side by side of full content with the summary as I'm learning. On the topic of help, this is a great use case for the chat with knowledge base feature. And I just have a lot of fun with this feature, particularly when it comes to my health protocol. So let me walk you through the way I would use chat with knowledge base. And just to recap on this feature, here you're chatting not just with one card, as you saw in the extension, here you're chatting with your entire knowledge base. So let's get to it. I might specify specific cards I want to speak to, and that's where you can use the at symbol. So I'll go at longevity. And that's just a tag that I have in my knowledge base. So all my research on health and longevity lives in there. Or in this case, I also had it under aging. And I would say, make me a longevity. So as you can see, it first will reference right at the top the actual cards that it's using to generate and create this protocol. So here I can see all of those cards that have been referenced. I then get an answer, which I've actually, I think this is a great answer, focused on physical activity, nutrition, lifestyle. So I really like the structure. But let's say I actually want to update this. So I've been working with a nutritionist and I might want this to now be tailored based on my specific nutrition plan. So I would say, I've got two plans. And so here I'm referencing two specific cards that I've actually have stored in my knowledge base. And so here you can see it's actually taken what it gave me previously and enriched it with my PDF or guide that I have from my nutritionist on how I should be eating, how much protein I should be having. And this is just, yeah, this is my perfect use case of the Recall Chat with Knowledge Base feature. And there's so much more that we can do with it from here. Next, though, I think I'll focus a little bit about how I use Recall when I'm on the go. So a great thing that I like to do when I'm on a run or let's say on a road trip is listen to a podcast. And there is so much great content out there, but especially when I'm listening to a podcast, I get irritated if I'm listening to something and I'm like, ah, oh, that's not actually what I want to be listening to. And you know, you're running and you're like, oh, this is the wrong podcast at this time. I actually like to use Recall as a bit of a pre-screen before I commit to that listening. So on my mobile device, I will just share the podcast directly with Recall. I will just get that summary, skims through it and decide if it's something I want to listen to, or I will chat with it to get particular learnings if I think that that is, you know, something I can learn. Is it worth my time? And yeah, that's sort of my pre-screen before committing to my podcast. And of course, when it's a great podcast, I love having it saved in Recall because I always know it's in a safe place that I can come back to again if I need to. We also support podcasts on the browser extension as well. So just as a quick recap, you click the browser extension. You can see again in just a few seconds, you get that summary. You can chat with the content, and it's also been automatically tagged and categorized. In this case, I might ask, since this is about AGI predictions, what are some And so again, just sort of skimming this, I can decide this looks like a good listen, and I'm ready to listen to the 4-hour-long podcast. Coming back to my knowledge base, and quite a fun use case for Recall is storing all of my movies. These are not full movies, these are actually just the Wikipedia pages of a movie. And a quick way that you can add a movie, is you can just click Add Content, and you can click on this little wiki icon, and here you can type in a movie that has been recommended or that you just want to have saved. So when anyone's asking you for your recommendations, you have it in your knowledge base. I was actually just recommended this movie, Weapon 2025. And so what you can see has happened is on the left, it's pulled the full Wikipedia page on what this movie is. It's not got a summary yet, so I can go to the chat tab, and here I might generate that concise summary and add it to my notebook. And with movies, it's actually something that I love to do is look at the connections. Because here I can see are there directors or actors or producers that are common with other things that I have seen before. I can see, Jordan Peele is mentioned. I don't actually think that he was a director here, but he was mentioned because there was a bid for the movie. A customer for Recall actually told me this whole story, which was really fun. But I can see he comes up. I can also see the three other videos that I loved. I don't know if anyone's watched Sinners. Really, really good movie. Get Out as well. I'm really into thrillers. And so here I love just exploring my connections. There might also be connections here that I'm like, these are not interesting to me. An example could be, a city that's mentioned. That's not really that interesting for me when it comes to a video. So I'll just click the unlink button and I would just unlink the cities that are mentioned because that's not relevant for me. Another thing I'll do is because I haven't watched this particular video, is I would then add my tag, a secondary tag, so it automatically tagged that it moved as movie, but I'll add a secondary tag, movies to watch. So when it comes to movie night and I'm not sure what to watch, so I have a quick list already going of things that I might want to watch. Another more personal use case, and I won't show you them because it's obviously my journals, but I like to come into Recall, create an empty note, I put it under my journals, and I would then take a journal on how that day went, some of the themes that came up to me. And this is actually a really nice use case where you can also chat with your own notes. So if you've taken a long journal entry, you can chat with it, which actually can be quite fun for even the chat with knowledge base because you can sort of pick up themes that are common in all of your journals. That's just a really fun personal use case of Recall where you're almost checking yourself in terms of what are some of the things that I've noticed in my routine or thought patterns that have come up? And that's like a great way that you can actually chat with really your own knowledge and your own notes to pick up patterns that you otherwise may have missed. And the last use case that I'll leave you with is my recipes. So I actually have a ton of great recipes in here, whether they're online recipes, which I just come in and save to Recall. So, for example, I just got an Instant Pot as a gift, which I'm very excited about, and I've been looking for some Instant Pot recipes. So, here I would just take the link, come into Recall, paste it in, and always know that. So, here it got it wrong. Here it put it as food. So, I would retag it as recipe. I might create a subcategory for Instant Pot, let's see. And I've got that full recipe. I've got my summary, or I might even just, this is another way where I would just chat and I would say extract ingredients. Just steps. Perfect. And now I've added that to notebook and I've got just the ingredients and the steps. Something that I like to do here is maybe start forming some connections. So whether it's flavor profiles or particular ingredients that I might want to connect in the actual recipe, there might be some key ingredients that I might want to highlight. So for example, this has lamb. I'll hit the lightning bolt and I will just select lamb or meat. Maybe there's some key flavors here as well. So cinnamon is quite noticeable. I'll add that. I might add Aleppo chili. And so, why do I do this? Well, when I now come to my connections, I can see all the different things that may be connected. So, for example, if I'm in the mood for something that has a lot of cinnamon, I have all the recipes that mention cinnamon in here, which actually brings me to another recipe that I will show you. And this was a recipe that I entered myself. So, it's very cute. I don't know if you've got, family recipes that you're excited to keep and save in a safe place, but for example, I've got amazing recipes from my granny. This is her crepe recipe, so like a very thin pancake. And so I just put in my ingredients, I put in the method, and then for the particular flavors, I then created those connections from them, and so that they're all in here. The last thing I will leave you with is just augmented browsing. So that was a big feature that we launched in April. I just have it on, and while I'm reading, I love seeing my little highlights pop up as I read. If you're not sure if you're seeing any, you can hover over your widget, and here I can see I've got 43 connections to something. And so even something small, like while I'm reading and I see the word neurotransmitter, I can see it's been mentioned 14 other times to previous content that I had looked at. And so just to recap on that feature, as you're browsing, it highlights keywords that you've seen before or that have been saved in your knowledge base and forms those connections. So for example, GABA is something that I have saved in my knowledge base. I saved it, David, ages ago. I might just want a quick recap on like, what was GABA? And so I can click on that and it takes me back to my recall card on GABA and then will specifically highlight where neurotransmitter was mentioned. Just to wrap us up, a routine I had gotten into and had broken a little bit was running my recall reviews. So in the evenings before bed, I loved to go onto my phone and just run a little recall review. Just a recap on what that is. If you have any content in your knowledge base, you can click the quiz tab and generate questions on it. So what this does is take the actual content and then we'll make a little quiz for you. So here I could just start my review on this particular YouTube video that we had just watched and just test my knowledge. What did I actually grasp? I love doing this after podcasts. What did I actually learn from all that listening time? But then the recall review feature is just a build up of that. So it would take all the cards that I've generated a quiz on, shuffle them up, and create a spaced repetition schedule for me. What that means is the more I get something correct, the less I'll see it. The more I get something incorrect, the more I will see it. And so it really just forces you to offset your forgetting curve when it comes to content that you've consumed. I will leave it at that. Thank you so much for your time. And if you've got some great use cases that maybe I've missed, please add them to the comments below. I hope this gave you some exciting ideas for recall. Keep us posted on how it's going. Cheers.